Hello and welcome to this course on how to get started with Enscape and Rhino. We'll cover how to install Enscape and what system specs are required. We'll also dive into navigation in Enscape, setting up materials, and rendering your first image. We will render a video, have a look at virtual reality, and much more. A lot to cover, so let's jump right in. If you haven't used Enscape ever before, you can apply for a 14-day free trial right away. To do so, visit our website www.enscape3d.com. Here, click the Get My Free Trial button, fill out the application form, and receive a link to download Enscape within minutes. Before you install Enscape, it's best to check if your system meets the necessary requirements in order to run Enscape properly. Enscape is Windows only. However, you can use it on a Mac too, as long as it meets our hardware requirements. Make sure to install Windows via Bootcamp to run Enscape in that case. Enscape requires an NVIDIA or AMD graphics card that supports OpenGL 4.4 and has at least 2 GB of VRAM. For virtual reality, we recommend to use an NVIDIA GeForce RTX 2070 or better for ideal performance. You should also make sure to use a graphics card driver that is not too old. If you haven't updated your graphics card driver in a while, consider visiting your graphics card manufacturer's website, NVIDIA or AMD.com, to update your driver. Installing Enscape is really straightforward. Just make sure Rhino is not running, double-click the installer file, choose the language you want to install in, and follow the installation wizard. Once the installation is finished, you should see the Enscape and Enscape Capturing toolbar in your Rhino interface. In case the new toolbars don't show up automatically, open the Rhino properties under File, enter the Toolbars menu, and enable Enscape and Enscape Capturing in the language of your choice. To start Enscape, just click Start in the Enscape toolbar. Enscape will open in a separate window and, after a short loading period, display your project automatically. We recommend to use Enscape with 2 monitors, but if you just have a single monitor and use Windows 10, use this trick to easily align both windows. Press the Windows key and the left arrow key at the same time. This will align the active window on the left half of the screen, allowing you to place the other one on the right. To explore the project, use the WASD keys and the mouse to navigate. Click and hold the left mouse button in Enscape and move the mouse to look around. Press the W key to move forwards. Move the mouse to steer the direction you're moving into. Use A and D to move sideways, S to move backwards, and E and Q to move up and down. To move to any destination quickly, just double-click the point you want to get to. If you feel like you're moving too quickly, you can dial down the movement speed in the general settings to get familiar with this form of navigation. Press space to enable walk mode to stay on the ground and enable collisions. To move through obstacles like doors, you'll need to switch back to fly mode briefly to disable collisions again. If you want to synchronize your movement from Rhino to Enscape, this is possible as well. Click the Synchronize Views button to lock your movement in Enscape to Rhino's active view. You can also use your Rhino-named views to navigate in Enscape. Simply select them in the View Manager here. You can also create named views from your current Enscape perspective by clicking this button. Enscape is not just reading values from Rhino. It is constantly connected to your project. Any changes you perform will update right away. Moving objects, changing materials, modeling or hiding objects, and so on. At this point, you can begin taking notes right in your visualization, be it to capture inspiration right when it occurs, or to communicate effectively with your team. Press the C key to bring up the collaboration annotation feature. Here, click Create Issue to generate a discussion point from your current perspective, or right-click any object and select Create Issue to reference that particular object. The new collab node will ask you for a state, title, and description. Once saved, it will automatically become part of the project file, along with all comments that are added. You can also choose to export your collab notes to a BCF file or synchronize them using BIMTrack. To set up materials for Enscape and Rhino, you can either use the Rhino Material Editor or the additional Enscape Editor. They are really comparable. The main differences are the Rhino Editor not supporting glossiness textures, while the Enscape Editor does. But honestly, the Enscape Editor is way faster to use, so I prefer it. To access a Rhino material in the Enscape Editor, you'll have to switch the type to Enscape. The Enscape Material Editor offers multiple material types, like grass, water, and clear coat, and all parameters necessary to set up almost any material convincingly, like roughness, self-illumination, and bump maps. Any more complex material consists of textures. There is plenty of sources online where you can find full texture packs. 95% of all materials will simply consist of three textures: color, displacement, and roughness. This example was found on www.cc0textures.com. Apply the color texture to your material and check the scale. If needed, click the texture thumbnail at the top and enable explicit texture transformation to change the dimensions. Enable bump and load the displacement texture. Adjust the strength and enjoy the sudden material detail. To control the reflectivity of the material, use the roughness slider. To control this attribute using a texture, just load the roughness map. Your first high detail material is finished. Use this workflow for wood, plaster, concrete, metal. Almost all materials look jaw-dropping with these three textures combined. To fill your scene with life, use our large collection of 3D assets. Open the 3D asset library and select a model of your choice to put a placeholder in your project. This has the benefit that your Rhino project is not weighed down by complex geometry, while Enscape is perfectly optimized for high detail visualizations. Before we render our first image, let's first choose a nice background. Go to the Visual Settings Atmosphere tab and select a horizon source or an HDRI skybox of your choice. Let's check the export settings in the Capture tab. I will leave the resolution at full HD for this example. We can also fine-tune the contrast settings in the Image tab. I'll also apply some depth of field because I love this setting. Now we can render the image. Just click the Render button to generate a high-quality picture to send to your client. To render a video fly-through, first press the K key in Enscape. This will open the video editor. Here we have our timeline that will later show your keyframes, buttons to create new keyframes or preview the video, and our total duration. Press K again to place your first keyframe. This is what it looks like. A keyframe is a point in time and space your Enscape camera will fly through when exporting the video. We can fly through our scene and gather nice perspectives as waypoints. Just press K whenever you want to capture a perspective in the video. Enscape will create a connected camera path automatically. You can always press the P key to preview your video. To preview starting from a particular keyframe, enter the keyframe by clicking on it in your scene or in your timeline, and press P now to start from here. To add new keyframes, click anywhere on the camera path and confirm. To move existing keyframes, enter them, move to the desired location, and press Enter or click Apply to confirm. To change the speed your camera moves in, have a look at the timestamp slider. This tells Enscape, reach this waypoint at second, whatever you select here. Grab the slider to select the desired time. This way you can also control daytime, zoom, and depth of field for each keyframe. Don't forget to press apply so your changes get saved. Once done, click the render video button to export the fly-through as MP4 file. If you have a virtual reality headset connected to your computer, you can simply press the Enable VR button to switch Enscape to VR mode. Teleport through the scene by using your controller as laser pointer by pulling the right trigger. Explore the menu hovering above your left wrist to change daytime or rendering style. Access the map or render an image in VR. Note that changes performed to the Rhino model will show up in VR right away. Everyone can watch on the screen what the VR user does. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial video. For additional info, check out the links below to our knowledge base or get in contact by hitting the feedback button in the Enscape interface. Also, visit our forums and share what you've achieved. In any case, have lots of success using Enscape.